Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to take some questions from the interim budget 2019. These questions are going to hold a lot of importance for the upcoming NABARD examination, the SEBI examination and the RBI examination. So without wasting any time, let's start with these questions, and following these questions I will be discussing important points of the interim budget with you. So do watch the entire video. So here is the set of questions on interim budget 2019. The first question is, as per Union Interim Budget 2019-20, the long-term capital gain exemption limit has been increased to dash for a taxpayer to be used only once in a lifetime. Please keep in mind, we are talking about long-term capital gain exemption limit, which is to be used only once in a lifetime. And the exemption limit has been increased to 2 crore, or to confuse you, they can also write it as rupees 200 lakh. Okay, let's talk about the second question. Under interim budget 2019-20, the limit for tax rebate for individual taxpayers who will not be required to pay any income tax has been increased to. Keep in mind, they are not required to pay any income tax, but they have to file returns. Okay, so the limit for individual taxpayers, if you know the limit, please provide your answers in the comment section below. Majority of the questions that we are going to discuss today are going to be factual in nature. The reason being, we are talking about the budget, and budget always has a lot of numbers. The answer to this question is A, rupees 5 lakh, plus a further exemption of 1.5 lakh is also provided if you invest your incomes under 80, section 80C. Let's talk about the third question. The standard deduction for salaried persons has been raised to dash under Union Interim Budget 2019-20. What is the standard deduction for salaried persons? The older standard deduction for salaried persons was rupees 40,000, but now it has been raised to rupees 50,000. Please remember these numbers. As per Interim Budget 2019-20, the committee is to be set up to complete the task of identifying denotified, nomadic and semi-nomadic communities not yet formally classified. The committee is to be set up under Ministry of Minority Affairs, National Commission on Minorities, National Commission on SCSTs, Niti Aayog and Ministry of Home Affairs. A very confusing question, I know that. If you know the answer, please provide it again in the comment section below before I tell you the answer, because I want to see how many of you are very well versed with the Interim Budget 2019-20, and at the same time I also want you guys to be answering these questions not only in your own head first, but also on paper, and that can be done if you write the answers in the comment section. The answer to this question is D, Niti Aayog. The next question is, under Interim Budget 2019-20, defense budget will be crossing dash for the first time in 2019-20 in the entire history of India. The answer to this question is A, rupees 3 lakh crore. It is the first time that the yearly defense budget is going to be crossing rupees 3 lakh crore. That is happening for the first time. Let's talk about certain important points related to the budget this year. Okay, so rather than just discussing certain questions, it's also important that we discuss major points of the budget, which will help you a lot in revising it faster. The first point is, India is now the sixth largest economy in the world, and it was 11th in the year 2013-14. So this number is important. Inflation stands at 4.6% for the previous year. Fiscal deficit stands at 3.4%. Based on these questions are certainly going to be asked in the examination. So please remember them. Do not forget them. CAD 2.5% of GDP, FDI 239 billion during the last 5 years, approximately $68 billion in the year 2018-19. Tax collection have increased to almost rupees 12 lakh crore this year. Important number. What is the vision for the next decade? I have created questions on these as well. Of course, did not discuss them today. We'll be discussing them in the future. To become a 5 trillion economy in the next 5 years and $10 trillion economy in the next 8 years thereafter. For poor and backward classes, 60,000 crores have been allocated for MG Narega in the budget estimates 1920. Very important allocation for MG Narega. How much? 60,000 crores. There are a total of 42 crore workers in the unorganized sector, and Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana has been launched for the same to provide help to these unorganized workers. So monthly pension of 3000 will be provided after these workers cross the age of 60 years. And to identify who is eligible, you need to be working first of all in the unorganized sector, and second is you need to be earning less than or equal to rupees 15,000 per month. How much do you need to contribute on a yearly basis? If you're joining at or below the age of 29, you need to contribute 100. If you're joining above 29, if you're joining at the age of 18, then 55. And third very important point, the government is going to deposit equal matching share. Whatever you are contributing, the government is also going to contribute the same amount of money. Defense budget, as I said, 3 lakh crore for the first time. Total railways budget, 1,58,000 crore this time. Rebate, as I said, rupees 5 lakh rebate and extra of 1,50,000 if you invest in section 80C, very important. So effectively 6.5 lakh, we've discussed these points. Deductions, additional deductions as interest on home loan. If you have taken certain home loan, the interest on home loan is deductible from your income tax, and the limit is rupees 2 lakh per year. Standard deduction for salaried persons, 50,000 from 40,000. Okay, it was 40,000 before, now it has been raised to 50,000. TDS threshold on TDS is tax deducted at source, threshold on interest earned on bank office deposits. If you are earning certain interest on bank deposits, you have to pay TDS if that interest is more than 40,000. So if your interest is more than 40,000, you have to pay certain TDS. If your interest is less than 40,000, you don't have to pay any TDS. Okay, so this was all for today's video. It was a short video, but very important. I am expecting 4 to 5 questions certainly in the upcoming examination directly from the interim budget, because that has always happened. Okay, if you like this lesson, do subscribe to the channel and do not forget to press the bell icon, because every morning at 8 o'clock, I come out with morning tales, and in those, a lot of interesting facts, important questions are discussed on a daily basis, and I believe that's the first thing that you should be starting in the morning. Very helpful for you guys. All the very best. Take care.